join. My name is Tim Gust. I am a mission manager with the VIPES project, and this is Marvin Grummer, a payload engineer with the VIPES project. VIPES is short for Visionary Ingenuity Boosting European Spacecraft, and it is a satellite research project of the City University of Applied Sciences, Bremen.
At VIPES, our main goal is to develop the digital satellite of the future, and to do that, we have to understand how especially the reaction wheels change their behavior in microgravity. Since they induce a lot of microvibrations on the satellite structure, we have to see how much it changes compared to the ground, and that's why we can test at GraviTower Bremen Pro, because it offers a great microgravity experience, and therefore we can see how the microvibrations change in that environment. To achieve that the reaction wheel is completely in free flight without any physical contact, we basically have a structure with some dampness underneath and at the top of the interface plate of the reaction wheel, and therefore we have some physical contact during the acceleration and deceleration phase. But when the GraviTower is in the microgravity phase, we have basically no physical contact, and therefore we can achieve perfect results.
We're using the test campaign here at the ZARM to prepare the measurement system that we're developing for a small spacecraft, which we call VIPES Pioneer. VIPES Pioneer is a 3U CubeSat that is roughly the size of a large water bottle. And we plan on launching the spacecraft towards the middle of next year. So we will actually get our measurement system to space. And to have the opportunity to test the measurement system in a microgravity environment here at ZARM is hugely beneficial for readying our system for space. And it's also a great opportunity for our entire team to get some hands-on research work. We're a lot of bachelor's and master's students, and for all of us, or for most of us, this is the first time that we actually do some hands-on science and research, and that's just a fantastic opportunity that's provided here for us.
We are using the GraviTower Bremen Pro instead of the big drop tower, which has a lot of advantages, especially because we can make rapid iterations in between our experiments and always have access directly after the drop. And that allows us to often change just some minor things and do some tweaks. And one of the biggest advantages in addition to that is that especially for our dampers, we can adjust our flight profile. So if we want to have some not that extreme accelerations, that's no problem for us, and therefore we can control extremely precisely how the reaction wheel floats inside of the capsule.